Hello and welcome to this hotel review and video tour of the Le Meridien Hotel in Chiang Mai, Thailand. As you can see from the outside, it's a tall building. At the entrance, there is the Le Meridien Chiang Mai logo. Here is the entrance outside. It looks nice, some green trees with two elephants, the symbol of Chiang Mai, and a small fountain. This is the lobby. The lobby looks elegant and chic, with big, soft and comfortable lounge chairs. The colors and the kind of marble pillars look, in combination with a high roof, makes it a beautiful lobby in my opinion. This is the check-in counter. After checking in, we get our welcome card with our room number. As we go in the elevator, we can see that the building has 22 floors, with the highest floors as the Le Meridien club rooms. We arrive at the 18th floor. Most of the hotel rooms are non-smoking rooms. And we walk through the corridor to our room. Our room number is 1810. Entering the room and showing a general overview. If the curtains are open, there is a nice mountain view. It's the famous mountain of Chiang Mai named Doi Suthep. The view outside is good, a nice city view with the mountain in the back. Unfortunately, it is a bit cloudy outside. Then we go back to the room again. In the room there is a TV, working desk, coffee and tea facilities, and a comfortable couch slash sleeping bed, and of course the hotel bed, which is also very comfortable. There are two lights, one light on every side of the bed, which can be turned on and off separately. There are two night drawers, one on every side of the bed. With a telephone, alarm clock, and pen and paper to write some notes. On the other side, there are two bottles of water with two glasses. The couch slash sleeping bed is very soft and comfortable. It's one of the things that I like about this hotel. Then we go over to the big working desk. It is pretty raw wood, and personally, I don't like it so much. but it fits good in the style of Chiang Mai. And there is a white desk chair. Personally, I don't like the chair because it also feels a bit raw, and more important, it doesn't have full back support, just lower back support. That's okay if you want to sit there like for an hour, but if you plan to work 6 to 10 hours, it's not that comfortable. The trash can also looks elegant. Some hotels have like a cheap plastic trash can, and we see the phone, TV remote, and all kinds of papers. The newsletter with some food and beverage promotions, and a welcome letter with the opening times of every part of the hotel. 4 power plugs near the desk. Coffee and tea facilities. Two Nescafe coffee sachets. That's absolutely 5-star hotel unworthy. These are very cheap coffee sachets, like $5 each, and the taste is absolutely horrible and cheap. I don't understand why 5-star hotels serve this kind of coffee to their customers that are paying more than $100 for a room. There are also 4 tea sachets, English breakfast, black tea, and green tea. And the minibar that has soda, beer, water, and orange juice, and snacks in the drawer of the desk, chips, chocolates, and dry fruit, and different kind of glasses, wine glasses, beer glasses, and normal drinking glasses. There are 2 empty drawers in the desk. I also don't like the drawers because they are vertical instead of horizontal. I can't imagine storing my laptop or all kinds of papers like that because they do fall a bit over and it just gets messy. The price list of the minibar, and that surprised me because the prices are very cheap. Around $60 for a can of soda and $90 for a chips or chocolates. Normally the price of that in 5-star hotels is like at least $3. Here we have the bedroom, a general overview. There is a large mirror with the sink. Tissues, hand towels, and a power plug. Two bottles of water with 2 glasses. Here we have the body lotion, a sanitary bag, shower cap, and cotton wool and ear sticks. At the sink there is a soap bar with lime smell from the brand Malin & Goods. Personally, I don't like the soap so much because it has a bit of an artificial smell. Next to the sink we have a mirror and 2 big towels and 2 small towels. And the bathtub with a bath mat. The bathtub is really good, it's big, large and deep, with a high pressure water tap so your bath fills up quickly. At some hotels you have to wait for ages before your bathtub is finally full. Next to the bathtub there is a big window which you can look through to see the room and even the TV. There is also a bathrobe available, which has a card on it, not to steal it by taking it away without paying for it. So apparently there are people who are taking bathrobes from hotels without paying for it. Then the toilet with a small trash can and a telephone. What I notified is that there is no toilet bidet, which are very popular in Asia, which gives a high pressure water jet to clean yourself. And then the shower. There are 2 showers, a normal shower and a rain shower. And 3 amenities from Malin & Goods. Peppermint shampoo, which I tried and I like it very much. Hair conditioner and body wash. Then the wardrobe, which has a bathrobe in it. Coat hangers to store your clothes. Clothes rack and iron heater. Two pair of bed slippers. They offer a service to polish and shine your shoes. and laundry service. Then we go to the fourth floor, where the swimming pool, gym, and spa are located. This is the entrance of the swimming pool. It looks like an oasis. Some chairs, tables, and sunbeds. I don't like that they have no beds on the sun chairs. The sun chairs are just raw. You are just sitting on the chairs without sunbeds. In proper hotels, they have like the thick sunbeds, which are way more comfortable. But unfortunately, many 5-star hotels these days offer their sun loungers near the pool without any proper sunbeds. And a beautiful view from the swimming pool. And they also have a kids pool. And the gym, which also has a nice view on the swimming pool and a nice mountain view. Thank you for watching, and it really helps me if you give this video a like and a comment to show your appreciation, so I will make more videos.